Hey, as promised, this is the second part of my chemical engineering story. If you haven't checked out the first one, I do suggest you watch that first. I will link it up here or down below. Just a quick recap, in the first video I talked about why I chose chemical engineering as a major in university, what a chemical engineer does, how I was as a chemical engineering student, the pros and cons of taking up Chem Eng, potential Chem Eng jobs, and when you should not take up Chem Eng, and ultimately whether or not Chem Eng was worth it for me. Now in this part two, I'll be talking about the schools you could take Chem Eng in here in the Philippines, 30 tips and tricks for chemical engineering students and engineering students in general, and the licensure exam or the board exam for chemical engineering here in the Philippines. So if you're ready, let's get into it. If you're here in the Philippines like me and you want to study chemical engineering, what are the top schools that you should consider? If you're not a local, please just skip this part. Disclaimer, I won't be mentioning all of the schools that offer chemical engineering here in the Philippines. I will just mention the top schools, and by top, I mean those that usually do well in the board exams. Let's start with the National Capital Region, or NCR. In Manila, there's De La Salle University, or DLSU, University of Santo Tomas, or UST, Adamson University, Mapua University, and Technological Institute of the Philippines. The most expensive school among these would definitely be La Salle, but they offer several scholarships there. I would know because I studied Chem Eng there for free, thanks to a private scholarship. If you're eyeing free tuition, there are state universities that you can apply to. In Metro Manila, there's University of the Philippines, Diliman, or UPD, and Pamantasan ng Lungsod ng Maynila, or PLM. UP Diliman was actually my originally planned path, but although I passed Chem Eng in UPD, I decided to take the road less traveled by and take up the full scholarship offer in La Salle. But if you pass UP, whether in UP Diliman or in other UP campuses across the country, I suggest that you take UP. Go study in UP. It's not the best school in the country for nothing. Sorry, La Salle. But if you do want to study in a private university, I would suggest DLSU. For the rest of Luzon, you have University of the Philippines Los Baños in Laguna, St. Louis University in Baguio City, which is a private university, Malayan Colleges Laguna, which is a private college, Batangas State University, and Bicol State University. In Visayas and Mindanao, for private universities, you have University of San Carlos in Cebu, Ateneo de Davao University in Davao, University of St. La Salle in Bacolod, and Xavier University in Cagayan de Oro. While for Visman State Universities, you have UP Visayas in Iloilo and Mindanao State University in Iligan. If you ask me, is the school you choose for chemical engineering that important? If you don't have an idea about the chemical engineering curriculum, how would you know, right? You would only be depending on the school's reputation or usual performance. But Google is your best friend here. Do your research, ask around whether online or offline. I do believe that the school you choose is important, of course, since you'll be spending 4 years or so there, but the school is only second to the student. It still depends on the person, how they'll find chemical engineering in school, how they'll maximize their learnings, how they will persevere through the course. Nevertheless, it will be best if you picked a school with a chemical engineering undergraduate program that is accredited by several renowned accrediting bodies. This is especially helpful if you want to work or pursue further studies abroad. If you've already chosen the school that you want to take up Chem Eng in, and if you're already eligible to study in that school, the next question is, how do you survive chemical engineering? How in the world do you survive Chem Eng? I can tell you because I'm a chemical engineer survivor. So take it from a veteran and take these 30 tips to heart. Yes, 30, it's quite a lot. By the way, these specific tips are not only for chemical engineering students, but also for engineering students in general. So in no particular order. Number one, make the most out of your first 2 years in university. Ace all the subjects that you can ace in your first 2 years to make up in advance for the next 2 to 3 years, which are usually more difficult. Number two, take well-organized, complete notes. Don't just take pictures or screenshots of the lecture, take down actual notes. Number three, set a study schedule and review days ahead of your tests. Please don't cram, please don't study just the night before your test. Don't. I've been there, no. Number four, avoid procrastination. The sooner you get things done, the better. Do not put off things to the last minute if you don't need to. Number 5, ask upperclassmen. Ask your seniors and they may be kind enough to share their notes or their previous tests with you, which you can practice on. Number 6, join clubs or organizations that are related to chemical engineering that can offer you help or get you connected with fellow chemical engineering students. Number 7, join study groups, but study at your own pace first. Two minds are better than one. You might get information or insights that you didn't know from your classmates. Number 8, make reviewers or just index cards on summaries, formulas, etc. It's good to have an overview of the topics that you're studying, and these reviewers will also be very helpful when you study for tests. Number 9, you don't have to memorize the entire periodic table of elements, and if I were you, I wouldn't. But it is helpful to memorize the commonly used elements and their important details. Number 10, invest in a good scientific calculator. You will be using it throughout uni, and if you're going to take the board exam, choose a calculator that is in the list of allowable calculators to be used in the board exam. Number 11, ask questions in class. Don't be afraid to ask stupid questions. If you're too shy to ask in front of the whole class, then you could just approach your professor privately after class. Number 12, actually read your textbooks. Don't just rely on your professors to feed you information. Textbooks provide elaboration that you might have missed in class, and they have more exercises that you can practice on. And speaking of practice, number 13, take a lot of practice tests. Pick a number of problems that you want to solve, go answer them, and review them before the test. The more you practice, the more situations you encounter, the better. But don't forget to go through them again, even just briefly, hours before the test, especially if you tend to have mental blocks like I do. Number 14, don't take failures too personally. I would say it's normal to fail a few subjects in Chem Eng, but don't slack off just because you've already failed a few subjects. You don't want to get delayed, because the longer you take to finish Chem Eng, the more tedious it gets. So don't let failure discourage you. Instead, use it as motivation to do better than you did before. Number 15, join extracurricular activities in school, but learn how to balance them with academics. Extracurricular stints like taking up leadership positions in organizations or volunteering will be helpful for your internship and job applications later on. Number 16, don't slack off on your thesis project or your capstone project. Do things in advance and anticipate possible problems or issues that can arise. These projects would take several weeks or even months to finish, so you have to be proactive enough so you can avoid serious problems and so you can finish the project on time. You don't want to delay your graduation because of your thesis project. Number 17, if you're planning to take the board exam, consolidate your notes after every term or semester so you won't have a difficult time gathering your notes to study for the board exam. And keep your notes legible. Ideally, you should be able to reread and understand your own handwriting. Number 18, don't forget your math, especially your algebra, trigonometry, and calculus. Math appears in most subjects in chemical engineering. Number 19, use your free time to get some rest instead of going on social media. Get at least 5 hours of sleep a day. Your brain won't function properly anyway if you don't get enough rest. So if you're already sleepy and you still need to study, just go sleep. But please, don't study on your bed. It's for your own good. Number 20, stick to your study schedule. If you get to build a study habit, then it will be easier for you to study, especially in times when you don't feel like studying. And number 21, take short power naps, 15 to 20 minute stops. Power naps can do wonders. But don't take long naps, because they will just make you groggy and they will just lead to a full night's sleep, which you don't want to happen because you still have to study for that test tomorrow. I'll sleep now and I'll just wake up early so I can study early. Number 22, choose responsible teammates for group works and be a responsible teammate yourself. Don't be a freeloader. Nobody likes a freeloader. Number 23, learn to get back up on your feet quickly. Chem Eng is a fast-paced course, so if you fail a test, just move on and study for the next test. Don't dwell too much on one thing, because there are so many other things that need your attention. But of course, you have to make sure that you understand the material enough. Number 24, if by any chance you plan to shift courses and move out of chemical engineering, do it before you reach your third year. If you really think that chemical engineering is not for you, then the earlier you shift, the better. Number 25, know how to navigate through your Perry's handbook. It's this big book right here that you will be using for some of your chemical engineering subjects and the board exam. And I forgot number 26. That's embarrassing. Number 26, if you get delayed, don't be discouraged. If you really want to graduate chemical engineering, just persevere to finish what you've started. Learn from your lessons and always strive to improve. Number 27, learn to manage your emotions. Time your breakdowns if you must. Complain less, work more. Don't waste your time worrying or being scared. Don't waste your time sulking over failed tests. Studying Chem Eng can be emotionally draining, but go help yourself and try to keep a positive attitude. Number 28, this is very important, do not neglect your mental health. At the end of the day, your mental well-being is still much more important than your performance in school, so learn to seek help when you need it. Number 29, get a healthy diet and find time to exercise. Aside from your mental health, your physical health is of equal importance, and you need energy and brain power, so be healthy. Number 30, don't forget to have a life. Don't forget to take breaks. Life is not after you graduate chemical engineering. Life is now, so go live it, enjoy it. Don't stress too much. You'll be fine. This too shall pass. And I'll give a bonus tip, which I understand might not be for everyone, but for me, this is the most important tip. And it is to go through the whole chemical engineering journey with God. To pray continuously, to seek and develop a relationship with Him, to rely on Him, especially at your low points, to ask wisdom and guidance from Him, and to work diligently to give Him glory. Jesus literally saved me so many times in university. If it weren't for Him, I would not be able to survive chemical engineering, the last 2 years of which were the most difficult, darkest period of my entire youth, I would say. And this is why I'm grateful for chemical engineering, because in Chem Eng, I met my savior, my very present help in times of need, the one who looks at my heart and not my performance, and the one who carries me when I don't have the strength to move forward anymore. That's Jesus. And Jesus made my chemical engineering journey worth it. Now, for most chemical engineering graduates in the Philippines, the journey doesn't end when you get your diploma, but when you get your chemical engineering license. You can be a licensed engineer if you pass the board exams, which happens twice a year. First one usually in May and the second one in October or November. Usually a few months after you graduate Chem Eng, you prepare to take the board exam, which lasts for 3 days and is divided into 3 portions. General engineering, physical and chemical principles, and chemical engineering, which are your majors. The first day of the exam is usually physical and chemical principles. This includes inorganic chemistry, analytical chemistry, physical chemistry, organic chemistry, biochemical engineering, and environmental engineering. And this portion of the exam is 30% of your final score or your overall rating. The second day of the exam is usually chemical engineering or your chemical engineering major subjects. This includes chemical engineering calculations, reaction kinetics, thermodynamics, unit operations, which is the bulk because it has so many subtopics, instrumentation and process control, a little bit of plant design, chemical process industries, and also you have your chemical engineering laws and ethics. I think biochemical and environmental engineering could appear in this day as well. Chemical engineering, I think, is the most difficult day of the board exam, and it's the one with the highest bearing as well. It's 40% of your entire grade. Finally, the third and final day of your board exam is usually general engineering. This consists of your engineering maths, your algebra, trigonometry, geometry, differential integral calculus, differential equations, and solid geometry, then physics, engineering economics, statistics, engineering mechanics, and strength of materials. These are the subjects you usually take in your first 2 years of uni, and they're called general engineering because other engineering courses like mechanical engineering and civil engineering also have these subjects. General engineering is the remaining 30% of your final grade for a total of 100%. Yay, math. In order to pass the board exam in the Philippines, you would need to get at least 50% in each of those 3 tests, and your overall grade should be at least 70%. It is tough, and the board exam is usually unpredictable, but people do pass the board exam with much suffering, I guess. Here, the national passing rate for the chemical engineering licensure exam is typically around 50%. That is 1 out of 2 people. I know that's scary, But don't let that discourage you, because even if you fail the first time, you could still take a second time, third time, but of course you have to aim to pass your first time. The Chemical Engineering Board exam is known to be very challenging, and even though each day of the exam is 6 to 9 hours long, a lot of the examinees still say that it's not enough. That's why ideally you have to prepare 3 to 6 months prior. Because the coverage is long and the topics are not easy, especially if you're not a big fan of studying like me, you really need to have enough time to review so you won't be too pressured or feel too frantic or anxious before the board exam. I'm not going to give specific tips to pass the board exam since I haven't taken the board exam myself. I was supposed to take the exam a few months after graduation, but then the pandemic happened, and so the board exam did not happen for 2 years. It kept getting postponed, and I didn't want to study until I was certain that it was going to push through. But when the board exams resumed, I was already looking for a job, and now that I have a full-time job, I do not have the energy and time to study for the board exam anymore. And more than that, I am personally not convicted enough to take the board exam. To tell you the truth, I have decided not to take the board exam anymore. And let me explain. I don't really have enough time and energy anymore to study for the board exams because my job is both physically and mentally draining. Nobody's forcing me to take the board exam either. My parents are okay with me not taking the exam. And actually, most of the people that I know who will be taking the exam are doing it only for their parents because their parents want them to. But as much as I want to make my parents happy, I would want to take the board exam because I want to. I'm okay without the engineer title. I'm okay without an honorific before my name. It's not like the job that I have right now is very much related to chemical engineering anyway. I mean, there's nothing wrong with wanting to get an engineer title, especially if you think that it's a reward for all of the years you studied in university. But for me personally, I don't think it's something you need to be successful or to go up the career ladder. I've also observed from a number of chemical engineering alumni that they don't really get to use their license, which by the way, you have to renew every 3 years. And to renew it, you would need to get CPD units, which you would need to spend time, energy, and not to mention money for. Adding to that, I know so many people who have been successful without a license or a title. And from my observation, the top companies don't require it anyway. And if we're talking about getting promoted, wouldn't it be more sensible for you to get promoted based on your actual work performance and achievements? Again, this is just my personal opinion. I have nothing against those who want to take the board exam. Heck, if I had enough time and energy, I would get that license myself. But it would only be for, you know, the feeling of accomplishment. And also to get an additional government ID. But honestly, I don't want to go through the hassle of renewing your license. And you have to know your priorities because life is short and our energy is limited. For me, this isn't my priority. My priority is my career and my YouTube channel, my online ministry. But if for you, your priority is finishing chemical engineering, then eventually taking the licensure exam and getting that license, then by all means, go for it, and I absolutely wish you well. But if you're like me, if you don't have enough conviction to take the board exam, it's okay, you'll be fine. It's not do or die, and you don't have to feel ashamed for not wanting to take the board exam. It's not sayang, it's not a waste or a shame. What's sayang is if you spend so much time and energy doing something that you don't really want to do, especially if you're being called to pursue something else now. So that's part two of my chemical engineering story, and I just want to take this opportunity to congratulate chemical engineering students, chemical engineering graduates, licensed chemical engineers, and chemical engineering professionals. Congratulations for making it through such a tough course, which I bet not only sharpened your knowledge and your thinking abilities, but also shaped your grit, your attitude, and your work ethics. Congratulations for being a survivor. Slow clap. And I say that in advance for those who will be taking up chemical engineering in the near future and for those who are still studying Chem Eng in university. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up, comment down below if this video helped you in any way, and please don't forget to subscribe to this channel. So that's it for this video. I'll see you in the next. Bye!